Agriculture is the basic industry for all of our nations, and often in our nations, the smaller producers have a difficult time getting a fair value in the marketplace. Again, did I get treated fairly? Was there somewhere I'd get a better price? So one of our goals, key goals of working together like this is to create better market transparency, not just for the big producers, exporters, but also for a small group of producers. So by making information available to all levels, the same information, you help level the playing field. The big guys and the little guys all use the same information. Guatemala had developed in-house a price bot. In other words, you could say, well, I'm looking for the price of white onions, and you get a response back from the computer says, oh, what size, or you know, what in what market? Oh, I want a large white onions. Boom, today's price is a phone bot, a price bot. So they created that internal to their ministry. Whereas people like USDA and our friends in Canada or the other major country or big countries, we don't have that same technology yet. So while the US has been doing this type of market information collection and dissemination for 105 years, we still haven't developed some of the tools that the smaller countries have with these smart people on the ground, like Guatemala.
From the experiences of the other countries, I've actually gotten inspired. In one of the first meetings that we had as an ICT panel, the member from Chile mentioned about using Power BI to do dashboards, etc., etc., and that got me interested in looking it up. I found that it was not a tool that we could use because we couldn't afford it. However, it forced me to look for alternatives, and I found an alternative which is open. Well, it's free to use, and I'm actually exploring using that now to create dashboards for us. Also, the experience that Guatemala has with Semagro has widened my eyes, if you will, or made me see that it's a tool that we could probably adopt in St. Lucia.
So as part of my experience here this week, we had a number of presentations, and one was specifically on machine learning. And it was a really very telling experience on kind of building the parameters around what machine learning is, what it's capable of, and how you can apply it in different settings. Through the discussion that we had after my pitch, one of the really nice things was that the expert on machine learning, we talked about it, and that we can actually build in some techniques and some tools in order to set kind of baseline what normal information looks like, and then use that to compare against our current information and identify information that's questionable easily without having to have somebody spend a lot of time physically looking through the information. So that in particular is of very heavy interest to me.